Hey everybody, and welcome back to my Fallout 3 BB Gun Run. You join us just coming out of Evergreen Mills, having made a quick stop at Smiling Jack to pick up some BBs, and there's raiders outside. Don't make me waste all the BBs I just got. There we go, mysterious stranger. Took him out, no problem. You used to have something good on you, why don't you? Today, we're still working on the main quest, making just a short hop from Evergreen Mills over to Vault 112. There's another raider out there, isn't there? Seems like only two raiders ever respawn in Evergreen Mills, which is nice. Means I don't have to deal with a whole bunch of them. And they're low level, so that's... Oh, I guess there's more than two. Normally I only ever see two here, which is weird. He's using a combat shotgun. Whatever. Bye, nerd. Maybe if he wings one of the escaped slaves, they'll actually help me out instead of just standing there like pansies. Alright, so, yeah, we're gonna head. After we get out of here, of course, we're gonna head it towards. Vault 12. This mission is going to be extremely uninteresting because it's not me shooting things with BB guns, it's just more plot stuff. So, I suppose it might be interesting for some of you who've never seen the game before, but I assume most people have. If not, well, I hope you enjoy it so far. I'm doing my best not to skip through conversations, which can be really annoying. Alright, we're gonna head this direction. Hey Doc, do you need a psycho? Doc. Oh, the raider with the flamethrower must have come from down from the church. Flamer fuel's free. Carry, so I'm okay with that. And yeah, here's the wastelander that he always chases. I don't know where that dude's going, though. I don't know where Doc's going, either. Only, you guys are weird. I'm not hanging out with you anymore. So yeah, we're just going to head right over this way and hope we don't run into Yaogwai and die. That would be nice. Actually, I'm kind of proud of the fact that even though I'm using a BB gun, I haven't died yet in this run-through, which is pretty cool. It's not like if I die, I'm going to quit the run-through or anything. I'm going to keep going. It's just makes me kind of happy I haven't bought the farm. Not that I'm saying I won't. I'm pretty sure I will die at least once through this run, because, like, I haven't done all the DLCs all that much. I've played each DLC probably once, which means that there's a good chance I'll die in the DLCs. There's some situations we get into later on that BB gun just might not cut it. And if I accidentally aggro a behemoth, I'm pretty sure I'm just gonna die. Unless I can run away fast enough, because I can't kill a behemoth. I think I might be able to kill a behemoth at like level 30, but that's 20 more levels from now. I'll give it a shot when I hit level 30. Yeah. So we're just gonna head over this way. And should be a red rocket that we're coming up on. Yeah, red rocket gas station. And that's where Dad is. You do want to be a little careful because there's a Mr. Gutsy over that way. We do not want to tangle with him if we don't have to. Mr. Gutsies are tough. So we're just going to sneak around. Stay over there, Mr. Gutsy. I don't want to tangle with you. We are a ninja in the night. Not really. If we had the ninja perk, sneaking would be a lot easier. Because the ninja perk means that you don't have to move like this while sneaking. You can move like this. Not this. This. Anyways, we're at Smith Casey's garage, which is the lead in to, I just went into caution, but we're just going to open the door. And if I remember right, all there is mole rats and rad roaches in here, so... Oh, hi. Didn't even see you there, buddy. Back to hidden. And mole rats are annoying, but no longer dangerous, which is kind of nice. One could argue they were never dangerous because the odds of them actually killing us before we shot them to death was minimal. But to me, they're dangerous because they just cost resources. Now they cost 7 or so BBs. Pick up that quantum and take around a look around for any good loot before we head downstairs. Ooh, tumblers today. That's totally worth picking up. A trunk with a cherry bomb. Cherry bombs weigh nothing, so they're worth taking. Fission battery? I don't think the Brotherhood wants fission batteries or conductors. I think they only want... Oh, didn't see you there, buddy. Sorry. Why are you so injured? Did I... Oh, are you the one that I was shooting before and I just didn't kill you? I'm a genius. Note that you can actually come to this garage at any point. We could have skipped all that going to GNR and then... Skip going to the GNR and then going to Rivet City and all that. You can run right out of the vault to this location, pull this lever, open up this door here. Did I miss? I missed. Die, mole rat, die. The only reason I'm dodging them is not because I think they'll hurt, it just saves resources. Oh, I fell down a hole. Stop it! Oh, bastards. It's sad when I want the mysterious stranger to come help me out with a mole rat. I'm like... And I really don't want him to hit those cars too much, because if you shift... Fallout... There we go. Thanks, mysterious stranger. Because the thing about Fallout 3 is, if you just, like, push this car around, there's a chance it could explode. Or explode the motorcycle around it. It's a little glitchy, if you haven't noticed. Alright. So yeah, we just head down this way. We're in Vault 12. Super easy to get to. And we're gonna go look for Dad. Open the door. I like how in Fallout 4 you need a Pip-Boy to open vault doors. It makes much more sense than people can just run up to the doors and open them whenever they want. Because there's no way that no one's never found that switch in 200 years. And, no one in this vault is hostile, so it's like, it doesn't make sense.
Welcome to Vault 112, resident. According to sensors, you have arrived 202.3 years behind schedule. Please redress in your Vault Tech issued vault suit before proceeding. If you have misplaced your suit, I am authorized to distribute a new one. Once dressed, please proceed down the stairs to the main floor so that you may enter your assigned Tranquility Lounger.
Thanks, lady.
Tranquility Lounger is available. Please be seated.
I could, or I could go explore and loot. Clinics this way. Dad, I know you're a doctor. Are you in here? Oh. Leather armor. Some stim packs. Worth the walk. Mentats. I have a lot of mentats, though. Metal armor and metal helmet isn't that bad if you don't mind the agility hit. Like, when I'm playing a melee character, I normally wear the metal stuff just because, well, one, it looks cool, and two, it actually has pretty decent DR when fully repaired. Door here. Right over this way. This is the overseer's office, which I do not believe we can get into. I believe it needs a way. Yeah, either. It needs a key, which I don't get. Alright, that's enough exploring. So we're gonna go do some, broken. There's Dad. Hi, Dad. So we're gonna hop in this Tranquility Lounger after we put on the Vault 12 jumpsuit. Vault 12 jumpsuit. Which, interestingly enough, looks exactly like all the other jumpsuits. It doesn't look special at all, which I find interesting considering you're basically plugging into a the Matrix. Yeah, I can't get into a hard lock, so we're just going to sit in the Tranquility Lounger. Sit. That closes down on us. And the world wibbles. That sound was all our gear unequipping because we don't have any of it. We're in Tranquility Lane. Now. Yeah, so basically the backstory. Oh, by the way, I don't know if you saw that. We're a little kid right now. Woo. With a man's face. We try to use our Pip-Boy.
Hey there, sport. Beautiful day, isn't it?
Sure is, say, Mr. Nesbom.
You should go talk to Betty. She's waiting for you over on the playground. Have fun, sport.
We try to use our Pip-Boy. Brings up this nice Pip-Boy watch. Awesome. Alright, so boils down to, that's Betty. Betty's actually a crazy old sadist scientist by the name of Dr. Braun. Yeah. That's our dad. He's a dog right now. Betty wants us to go do a bunch of sadist stuff and, like, hurt people and make... Well, you start by making Timmy Nosebim cry and do all this other stuff. Or we can completely ignore her, walk into this room, and activate the failsafe. Because we're in the Matrix and there's a failsafe to kill everybody in here. So, we're going to Granted, just do it the easy way, which is you activate these to make musical notes. So, radio, pitcher, gnome, pitcher, cinder block, gnome, and bottle. There we go, failsafe initialized. Then we just walk up here. And basically these are entries about Dr. Braun being like, oh, paradise sucks. I was evil for a long time and I hated that. And now I'm in Tranquility Lane making these people do horrible things and I love it. Whatever. Alright. Basically, the failsafe will kill all the other people in the loungers, saving them from this hell of being tortured by Braun for all eternity. And we don't have to get bad karma because we murdered Braun. Well, we do all the Braun stuff Braun says. So yeah, these Chinese soldiers are just going to murder those people and we can go talk to Braun. Hey, Braun. What did you do? I let everybody out, so bye. Didn't even have to talk to him to finish that quest. And Dad gets let out. Super easy. Oh man, I forgot how scruffy my hair is.
Son, you've saved me. I was afraid I'd be trapped in there forever.
It took me like 4 minutes, Dad.
But what are you doing here?
I came to save you.
Well, I'm glad you did. This certainly wasn't how I expected things to turn out. I wasn't ready for Braun, or I might have fared better.
Good thing I showed up to save you.
It certainly is. It's nice to feel that I'm on two legs again. And thanks to Dr. Braun, I know that Project Purity isn't lost after all.
What did you learn?
I was right about Braun. The technology he developed is unstable, even dangerous, but it can be adapted for Project Purity. I need to return to Rivet City and talk with Madison. If we can find a Gek, we can make Project Purity work.
So he's talking about a mystical-esque device that exists in Fallout called the Gek, the Garden of Eden Creation Kit, that can actually... It's like kind of like a nuclear bomb that when you set it off, it saves the world. Anyways... It terraforms the world back to a better place. So, all right, let's go to Rivet City.
Yes. With what I've learned, Madison is sure to see that we can finally succeed where we failed so many years ago. I'd like you to come with me. I'd like you to be there when we finally open the floodgates.
Sure, Dad.
That's my boy. Let's hurry. Now that I know what we need, I want to get back to work as soon as possible.
All right, and we get 600 XP, raising us to the next level. Can we just talk for a minute?
Of course, son. What's on your mind?
Nothing.
All right.
I don't want to yell at my dad. I like my dad. What is Project Purity?
It started as an idea, really. Remember the Bible passage your mother loves so much?
Yeah, the one about the waters of life.
Free, clean water for everyone. What a difference it could make in the lives of everyone here in the Wastes. Over time, that idea took the form of a purifier. Not like the one in the vault, though. This one was gigantic, capable of purifying millions of gallons of water at once. We used the old Jefferson Memorial for the location, right on DC's tidal basin. Someday soon, I hope you'll see it work.
What happened to Project Purity?
In the year before you were born, things became difficult. There had always been something of a mutant problem in the city, but it became worse. They attacked more frequently and more aggressively. Support for the project eroded as time went on, when we couldn't produce any significant results. Progress came to a halt. And then you were born.
Whoa, you're blaming me?
About what to do when that time came. But then we lost her. and I had to make a decision. I chose to leave. From what I understand, things happened quickly after that. It became too dangerous for the others to stay, and so the project was abandoned. Dr. Lee and her team left for what became Rivet City, and Project Purity has sat waiting ever since.
Alright, have to go, Dad.
Be careful, my son.
And we level up. So we just hit level 11. We got 18 skill points to spend. I'm going to push up speech to 80 and sneak to 90, leaving us 2 points to spend somewhere else. Honestly, I'm just going to keep pushing sneak up. Continue. At level 10, let's see. Are we missing any perks at 10? Nerd Rage, which we won't be getting, but, we could pick up Mr. Sandman, which is really nice. It allows you to silently kill people when they're sleeping. Or Finesse, which raises our ability to, score critical chances. But more importantly, we have Animal Friend, which means bears no longer want to eat my face. Which means we can explore much easier now. So we basically neutralized ghouls with our ghoul mask and all animals. Not insects, though, so like rad scorpions are still a pain. But mole rats we no longer have to shoot. Same with, a lot of things like that. So you don't actually have to follow Liam Neeson back to Rivet City. He'll make it there all by himself, no problem. Close this. I don't want anybody actually finding their way down there. Still gotta worry about that Mr. Gutsy, though. There's a Protectron that way, too. That's probably what saw me right before I went into the, I'm not wearing any armor. Yeah, let's put that stuff on. Get out a BB gun. I guess Dad is waiting for me. I guess we'll follow him back to Rivet City. Might be able to just fast travel there, but why not? It sounds like fun. Little father-son excursion. I want him to see how good of a shot I've gotten with my BB gun. Whoa. Dude, you're a doctor. Don't run in radiation, you moron. You know, that's one of the things that always bugged me about this game. When you set your dad free, he doesn't function like a doctor, so you can't actually get him to heal your wounds or anything. And I'm like, that'd be really nice if you could. So he's immortal, so we don't have to super worry about him. Have fun, Dad. I'll meet you at Rivet City. So we're just going to run far enough away that rad scorpion isn't a problem, and then fast travel to Rivet City. Just trying to get far enough away that no enemies are detecting me. Nope, still enemies nearby. I could keep heading that way, but I saw a blowfly, and I'm going to try to avoid that too. Is rad scorpion coming after me now? No, Dad's still punching it to death. He'll be fine. Huh. I think I've been here before. Oh, I was here in one of the episodes where my game crashed and I couldn't keep playing. Yeah, this is a little, like, Jocko's popping gas stop. No, I guess I've never been here before. Yeah, this mole rat shouldn't be unfriendly to me. That rad scorpion is, though. Yep, I remember now. There was rad scorpions everywhere. Come on, mysterious stranger. Maybe this isn't the place I'm thinking of. No, it's not the place I was thinking of at all. That's somewhere else. I wonder what's in here. Food? I like food. Nuka-Cola Quantum's the big loot. Oh, actually even better, Nikolai Tesla than you. That's good. We're probably going to get jumped when we step out of here. That's what I always assume when I walk in somewhere that has nice stuff. Bottle cap mining schematics. That's great if you're playing any sort of explosives build. Let's read that Nikolai Tesla in you. I am that tumblers today I found. That goes up. That goes up. And then we're going to just sneak our way out of here. I guess I won't get jumped. Since that mole rat's friendly, we should be able to just fast travel to River City. And, Dad's already inside. Oh, no, he's still all the way back there. Is he coming? I might have to go back and talk to him. Oh no, he's making his way there. Look, we can actually watch his real-time movement. Wait for another hour. He's made his way past the Robco facility. Yeah, so we can just, we'll go see if, Black or Shrapnel has any BBs while we wait for Dad to show up. Dad, you're really slow when you can't teleport. Wow. Now that I think about it, that might be the Lone Wanderer's most amazing super ability power, the ability to teleport everywhere in the wasteland. Not instantaneously, but still. Really a lot faster than walking, as you can see.
Have you seen my good-for-nothing son, James?
Decided to check out.
What do you have for sale? Nothing worth buying here. You want to buy my stuff? Ball cap mine. Curtain of cigarettes, cherry bomb, pack of cigarettes, and wonder glue.
Give me a shot if you.
Let's go see if,
Morning.
You're the lady that made me have good karma and have to fight Talon Marks.
Nice to see you again.
More psycho. Always buy more psycho if I got a choice. Dad, you here yet? Are we there yet? Are we there yet?
Morning.
Are we there yet? Are we there yet?
Everything looks okay right here.
Dad should be right over there now. I don't know what he's doing. Let's go find out. Maybe he's getting a tussle with that big old super mutant brute who lives up on that hill over there. Or he just got stuck. Come on, Dad. Taking forever. Also, what have you been doing? Your suit looks like you've been rolling around in grease and mud. Well, if I put on my Vault 101 jumpsuit, which I sold, but it looks perfectly fine. Best part of having Dad with me is I won't get lost trying to trying to make my way to the science lab. As long as I don't lose him. Here's Dr. Lee. Man, I hate this lady. She's such a bitch. Like, if I could murder her, I can't, but I would, but I can't, because she is always essential.
I told you it would work, Madison. And now I can prove it.
James, you're back.
And with good news. I was right about Braun and the Geck. If we can find one, we can adapt it to work with the purifiers.
I'd like to believe you, James. I really do. This is all just so... so sudden.
Madison, I'm telling you, this is real.
You're easily amused, eh?
I talked to Braun himself. He confirmed it. Don't you see? This is what we've been waiting for.
I don't know, James. So many years have passed. Is it really still worth trying?
How could it not be worth improving the lives of everyone in the wasteland? What could be a more worthy endeavor?
You haven't lost any of your passion, have you, James?
It's as important to me as ever, Madison. I know it's important to you, too. Let's finish it together.
James, we don't have a Geck. I can get a small team together, but we'll need proof that it works before people believe us.
I can find a Geck.
I know, I was thinking about that. The lab at the facility had some old pre-war computers that we scavenged. One of them might be useful.
From the last reports, there's no power at the facility. Even if one of those computers had a database, we couldn't access it.
That's why we're going to head over there right now and get things up and running as best we can.
You know, if it were anyone else asking me to do this, I'd have them run right out of Rivet City.
You're easily amused.
You know,
eh?
I wouldn't be here if I didn't think this would really work. It's time, Madison.
Damn you, James. When this is all over, you owe me a drink. I'll get the team together.
Thank you, Madison. It's good to be working with you again.
Did you need something?
Is everything all right?
What's up, Dad?
I need to get back to Project Purity. The computer there is our best chance to locate a Geck.
All right, let's get going.
That's my boy. It'll be good to work side by side with you, son.
Which is why you left me in the vault. Yeah. He was a robot.
It's a tough job. I wouldn't want it.
Just gonna steal all this fresh fruit. Fresh food's pretty awesome. It's just as good as like pre-war food with no rads. All right. Why is there one Instamash in here? Maybe that's the, like, the lunch break room or whatever. Anybody over here? Anything good over here? Nobody can see me. Yeah, so, I guess we could take a quick nap, too. I guess we can. So, having found our dad trapped in a horrible matrix that I completely ignored all of the relevant plot and let him out by knowing the game, having played the game before, we're now going to head back over to the Jefferson Memorial, and our dad's going to send us downstairs to go kill superheroes. But I think we're actually going to call it a part here. I hope you enjoyed the episode. Join us next time as we continue along the main quest line of Fallout 3. Bye.